I'm going to read you a story tomorrow. Promise you'll come and see me?
Of course I will. We're ready for you now, Tracy. Time to get you ready to see the doctor. Perhaps you better go now.
Can't Jane stay?
Just for a minute? Oh, all right, I guess. Thank you. Would you like me to look after Teddy for you?
Yes, please. Make sure he eats up all his food.
Of course I will. And you're not to worry. Everything will be fine. Put your arms out.
Down. I'm a bit frightened.
There's no need to be. You go to sleep and when you wake up you'll be all better and I'll be there to see you as soon as I can.
You're my best friend.
Ruth Ballinger will be arriving soon. I want everyone to understand the situation.
Well, I've told all available staff to assemble here at 2:15 for that meeting you wanted.
Thanks.
How did they manage to nab her?
Perhaps they were tipped off about her arrival. Anyway, when she landed, she was found in possession of heroin.
But the paper said that she's insisting that the federal police planted it on her.
Oh, she's hardly likely to admit to anything, is she?
Well, whatever happened, the federal police are determined to smash her husband's organisation.
Oh, well, they've been after him for years. I mean, he's a multi-millionaire and has earned every cent from drug trafficking, international crime and extortion.
Well, and getting his wife is the first bit of luck they've had, I suppose.
Exactly, and they're going to use it too.
Hey, she's a very attractive woman, used to living in the lap of luxury.
Well, luxury she won't be seeing again unless she gives them the information they want.
All of which places us in a very tricky situation.
Oh, what's her husband's name again?
Arnie, isn't it? Arnie Ballinger? Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's it. Paper said he doesn't think twice about having people bumped off if they get in his way, I mean.
Or his wife's.
Yes, exactly. And if he hears she's having a bad time here, we could be next on his hit list.
Oh, I wouldn't get too worried if I were you. I've had orders from the department she's to be given special treatment.
Like what?
Anything she wants, within reason.
Well, that could cause some problems. Well, what are the others going to think when they see her getting privileges they don't have?
I don't like it any more than you do, but that's the way it's got to be.
I'd like to bum her scrub, eh, Taffy? You're into one of your moods, eh, you love?
Oh, I'm feeling a bit sad that we're only allowed to go outside once a day,
this one. Don't worry, love. We'll find you some more plants from somewhere. You all right, Nora? We know you. Been cheating the girls again, have we?
I don't cheat anyone. Just done a bit of business with Tanny. She had a book of crosswords and she'd filled up all the answers. And do you know she wanted to rub them all out and start over again? Isn't that exciting?
Oh, breaks my heart.
Trouble was, she didn't know her
brother. Oh, don't tell me. You can help.
You should have seen her face when I gave it to her.
Gave it to her?
Broke my heart to see how a little thing like that could please someone so much.
Have a good cry, did we?
She gave me a hanky for the rubber.
Well, that'll be useful, won't it?
I don't know. I'm too soft for my own good, if you ask me.
Soft you? You haven't got a soft bone in your whole body.
How would you know?
How would I know after what you did to me?
Didn't do anything.
Well, you're right there. If you'd been half the fence your father was,
that's
wouldn't
right,
be
blame me as usual.
Well, are you denying?
Oh,
stop it! Just shut up!
Oh, I can't stand this anymore. Oh, poor Taffy. She looks like she's building up to something.
I hope she's not getting into one of her states.
Could be.
Well, we're going to have to look after her. We don't want her getting into trouble, do we?
Got any remand prisoner for you, Mrs. Ballinger.
You're expecting her, we understand.
Oh, yes. And you are?
Federal police.
Oh, I see.
Her papers.
Oh, thank you. Now, Mrs. Ballinger.
I presume I'll be able to have my luggage in my room.
Well, it's not...
I'm sure you'll be able to arrange it for me, won't you? Your name is...
Barry. Mrs. Barry.
And I'd like you to take special care of my coat. Mink needs careful handling, as I'm sure you know.
Oh, yes, of course. We'll have to hold all your jewellery here, I'm
Naturally.
Afraid.
Naturally. It wouldn't be safe for me to wear it in a place like this now, would it?
No. Oh, what a beautiful ring.
Yes, it is quite nice. The diamonds come from my husband's mine near our estate in South America. You have it, Mrs. Barry.
Oh, no.
Oh, please, I'm tired of it anyway.
Better be careful, Mrs. Barry. That could be construed as an attempt to bribe an officer.
Oh, really? I was just looking at it.
I'm sorry Willie and me went on like that, but you know what we're like.
It's all right.
You're not getting one of your headaches again, are you?
Oh, it hurts, honey, Maddie.
Oh, there.
I just want to get away from here and never come back.
Oh, that's only because it's a new place.
I haven't even got any of my flowers.
We'll see about getting you some more.
Blue-brack, the only one I had.
Would you like me to see if I can get you a dorm change?
I wouldn't let you.
Look, I can try.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, look, love, everything's not always hopeless.
It is.
Only when you're like this. But you'll soon be over it and back to your old happy self again.
Yeah, well, I just wish it was over now and I was dead.
Now, look at yourself. Look what you've done to yourself before when you've been like this.
Oh, honey,
that's why you mustn't let go. You've got to fight it, Daffy. Look, I know it's hard, but you've got to try.
I'll try.
So, although we've got no option but to go along with the directives about Ruth Ballinger, I'm determined her being here is not going to cause more problems.
Well, we've got all the elements for trouble. I mean, the tougher discipline.
Except for one privileged prisoner.
Oh, and resentment of that from the other women.
And what happens when Joan gets back? She has been known to go over the top as far as discipline is
concerned. I'll be making it quite clear to Miss Ferguson what the limits are.
Oh, look, I didn't mean to suggest that you
did. I know what you meant. But what's worrying me more than Joan's return is the fact that the women are bored as well as restless.
Well, that often happens when their friends are released, when they start to remember what they're missing on the outside.
Exactly, that's my point. And that's why I want to start up the activity programs again.
Oh, I think that's a knockout idea. Well, the Borstal lassies to work with back home came up with some great things.
Like what?
Well, one group of lads actually built a canoe, for instance. Yeah, from scratch. It cost a pretty penny, mind you.
Yes, and that's the trouble. I've already spoken to Mr. Fry, and he's not willing to come up with any extra money for materials. Well, I can't see our women wanting to build canoes anyway. No, but they've done some very creative things in the past.
Well, even Len Murphy's classes gave Bobby Mitchell a good start when she was released.
That's true. Yes, but I don't want to make it sound too educational. I mean, there are all sorts of things we could do that aren't going to cost any money.
I used to run a general knowledge class at Borstal. I could try that again. Well, it sounds a bit daft, I know, but even the thick ones used to get a buzz out of it when they got an answer right.
Oh, well, could you start organising that, Ben?
Right.
Let's hope the women are interested.
Not quite the Savoy, but I'm sure I'll be able to make myself comfortable.
I'll have to ask you to unpack the suitcases and then they'll be put in the store.
Yes, well, there doesn't seem anywhere here to store them, does there? Not much wardrobe space either.
I'll be taking you to see the governor shortly.
How very social.
In the meantime, you should make your bed and get yourself organised.
Make my bed. Well, that'll be a trip down memory lane.
Oh, and here's the rule book. You want to read that?
Of course. We must stick to the rules, mustn't we?
Well, I'll be back shortly.
Thank you, Mrs. Barry.
Now, are you sure you know what to do?
Yeah, I think so.
Off you go then. Any trouble, you come back and see me.
Okay.
You needn't worry about her. She won't cause any trouble.
Yeah, not if she handles the skip as well as she does cards.
Chucky's a good girl.
Not like some you brought from Barnhurst.
Who did you have in mind?
That one for a start. Going berserk in maternity. Cut it, Kelly.
Why? Can't she face it?
Nothing to face, Kelly. I wasn't going to hurt the baby.
Oh, sure. I bet you forgot what you're in here for.
Leave it and get on with your work.
Why should I leave it? She knows what she did.
Nora wouldn't hurt a fly.
Shouldn't she kill a baby? She killed three adults, didn't she?
That was 23 years ago. 23 years ago, you... Oh.